Welcome, class. I hope you are okay taking care of you and your family at home. Remember to wash your hands, and if you have to go out for your safety and ours, wear a mask to cover your mouth and nose. Hello, I am Margie Garcia, and I'm going to be your teacher in this class. Today we are going to learn and talk about adverbs of time. Let's start. Do you know what adverbs of time are? Fantastic! Here I have some pictures. What can you see in the pictures? Excellent! And what do calendars and clocks work for? Good! Now, let's start to learn and talk about adverbs of time. Let's go. Adverbs of time tell us when an action happened, but also for how long and how often. There are three types of adverbs of time. When, that is used when asking for the time. For example, when did you arrive? ¿Cuándo llegas? How long is used to know the duration of the action. Example, how long does it take you to get to the gym? It takes me 30 minutes by bike. Nos dice la duración de la acción. Y how often, that tells us the frequency of the action. Example, how often do you go to the gym? I go twice a week. Nos dice qué tan seguido realizamos la acción. Cada type of adverb has word that describe it the best. Para when, there are today, hoy. Repeat. Today. Again, today. Yesterday, ayer. Repeat, yesterday. Again, yesterday. Later, después. Repeat, later. Again, later. Now, ahora. Repeat, now. Again. Last year, el año pasado. Repeat, last year. Again. Para how long, there are all day, todo el día. Repeat, all day. Again. Not long, no tanto. Repeat, not long. Again. For a while, por poco tiempo. Repeat, for a while. Again. Since last year, desde el año pasado. Repeat, since last year. Again. Y para how often? Sometimes, a veces. Repeat, sometimes. Again. Frequently, frecuentemente. Repeat, frequently. Again. Never, nunca. Repeat, never. Again. Often, a menudo. Repeat, often. Again. And yearly, annual. Repeat, yearly. Again. Aquí tenemos oraciones. Si ustedes pueden observar, las palabras que están en rojo son los adverbs of time.
La primera sentence es una pregunta. Is today Friday? Hoy es viernes. La segunda. Yesterday was a sunny day. Ayer fue un día soleado. And the last one. I will see you later. Las veré después. Nos dicen cuándo sucedieron las acciones. Here we have more sentences. Boston now is a great city. Boston es ahora una gran ciudad. And the university graduated 500 students last year. La universidad graduó a 500 estudiantes el año pasado. Como pueden observar, los adverbios de tiempo nos dicen cuándo sucedieron las acciones. Here there are two examples. First, the festival is an all-day event. El festival es un evento de todo el día. And second, hello, it's not long since your last visit. Hola, no fue hace mucho tu última visita. Aquí los adverbios nos indican la duración de las acciones. Aquí tenemos otros dos ejemplos. El primero, she has lived in Switzerland for a while. Ella ha vivido en Suiza por un tiempo. Y el segundo, his restaurant is open since last year. Su restaurante está abierto desde el año pasado. E igual, aquí los adverbios nos indican la duración de las acciones. Look at these examples. Sometimes I take the bus. A veces tomo el bus. And they frequently visit Paris. Ellos visitan París frecuentemente. Aquí los adverbios nos indican qué tan seguido realizamos las acciones. Let's look these examples. He never drinks soda at work. Él nunca toma refresco en el trabajo. They often jog at noon. Ellos trotan a veces en las tardes. And they celebrate her birthday yearly. Ellas celebran su cumpleaños cada año. Igual. En estos ejemplos, los adverbios nos indican qué tan seguido realizamos las acciones. Let's read questions and give possible answers using adverbs of time. Iniciemos con when. When did you start to drive your car? Una posible respuesta con today puede ser I started to drive my car today. Y una posible respuesta con yesterday puede ser I started to drive my car yesterday. Recuerda, when nos dice cuándo ocurrió la acción. Vamos con how long. For how long have you been driving your car? Una posible respuesta con all day puede ser I've been driving my car all day. Y una posible respuesta con since last year puede ser I've been driving my car since last year. Recuerda, how long nos dice cuánto tiempo duró la acción.
Ahora les voy a hacer una pregunta con how often. How often do you take the bus? Una posible respuesta con sometimes puede ser I take the bus sometimes. Y con frequently puede ser I frequently take the bus. How often nos dice qué tan seguido sucede la acción.
Ok, it's time to practice. Vamos a leer unas oraciones que están desordenadas y vamos a tratar de ordenarlas. Recordarles que todas las oraciones que les voy a presentar son de las que hemos visto previamente. Ready? Let's go.
Aquí está la primera scramble sentence. I drive today to car started my. ¿Cuál es la forma correcta de escribir la oración? Exacto. The right way is today I started to drive my car. En español eso sería hoy empecé a conducir mi carro. Second scramble sentence. Yesterday I started drive car I to my. What is the right writing? Well done. The right writing is, yesterday I started to drive my car. Okay, and the last scrambled sentence. Started, drive, car, year, I, to, my, last. What is the right way? Good. The right way is, I started to drive my car last year. Next scramble sentence. All, I've, driving, my, day, car. Can't you tell me what is the right writing? Exactly. The right way is, I've been driving my car all day. Second scramble sentence. My, drive, frequently, I, car. What is the right writing? Great! The right writing is, I frequently drive my car. Last scrambled sentence. Bus, sometimes, da, I, take. What is the right writing? Good job! The right way is, sometimes I take the bus. Let's go to read a reading in where you are going to identify the adverbs of time that are in it. I'm going to give you a clue. The adverbs of time that we've been seeing in the class are in the reading. Ready? Let's go! Mary is a pilot. She started traveling when she was 23 years old. Since that day, she hasn't stopped. When she's back home, she tells her family about her travels. Last year, she traveled to Dubai. She told her family the trip took all day. Now, she is still doing international day but no long trips. Yesterday, she went to Cancun in Mexico, and today, she traveled to Roatan in Honduras, and later she will travel to Panama City in Panama. Now, she is teaching her daughter to follow her steps. Often, she takes her to her trips, but never in the cabin, always as a passenger. Okay, tell me what adverbs of time do you find in the reading? First, last year. Second, all day. Great. Third, now. The next one, not long. Number five, yesterday. Six, today. Seven, later. Very good. Now is again. Eight, often. The next one, never. And the last one is always. Very good. Now is your turn. Can you read the reading by yourself? Don't worry, I will for you to read it. Here I have some questions about the reading you previously did. Ready? Let's start. First question, When did Mary start traveling? Very good. She started when she was 23 years old. Recuerden dar las respuestas completas. Second question. How long took her trip to Dubai? Good. It took all day. Third question. How often does she take her daughter to her trips? Great. She often takes her daughter, but never in the cabin, always as a passenger. And last question. When did she travel to Roatan? Good job. She traveled today to Roatan.
Knowledge is for sharing, and it was a pleasure for me to share it with you. Never stop learning. Recuerda compartir el conocimiento aprendido. Ese es su propósito. You did a great job. Claps for you. Students, it's time to say goodbye. I hope you like it. I am Miss Garcia. See you next time. Bye.